Morning friends, today we'll discuss one small dermatological concept. So before proceeding for that, can you be able to analyze these two images? Can you analyze these two images? So let me explain these two images. So in first image we are seeing some animal which contains some dome shaped cell, and in second one the two persons are shaking their hands. Can you be able to correlate these two images? So one is in the second image they are touching their hands, they are shaking their hands, so it indicates there is a contagiosum, that is skin to skin contact. In second image there is something called as dome shaped and dome shaped lesions, the animal is molluscum. That is, in second year PUC, you might have heard about invertebrates. There is one family called as mollusca. It means that it is contains a dome shaped cell. So that is the reason it is a molluscum. So dome shaped and contagious. So nothing but a molluscum contagiosum. So friends, today we are going to discuss about molluscum contagiosum virus and its lesions. So coming for the introduction. Molluscum contagiosum, as already told, contagiosum means skin to skin contact. The virus is going to spread by skin to skin contact. And the molluscum, because it produces the dome shaped lesion. So hence the term molluscum contagiosum. So molluscum contagiosum, it is basically a viral disease, that is a DNA virus, belongs to a family called as Poxviridae. Under the Poxviridae, it belongs to a genus called as Molluscipox. The genus Molluscipox. So this is one peculiar feature about the molluscum contagiosum is it is a DNA virus. It is the largest DNA virus infecting the humans. It is the largest DNA virus infecting the humans that can be seen through the light microscope. So most of the viruses are seen in the electron microscope. This is the only exception where this virus is seen in the light microscopy. So this is a very MCQ corner point. So in your MCQ, you will be getting all of the viruses are seen in electron microscopy except in that molluscum contagiosum is the option. So then go for the molluscum contagiosum. Coming for the clinical features. As already mentioned, it is a contagious spread, that is spreads by skin to skin contact. So most of the patients present with the skin cutaneous lesions. So can you able to describe or decode this skin pathology? So you should decode the skin pathology in 2-3 terms. One is it normal or abnormal? Obviously it is abnormal. So is it the skin lesion, is it a well circumscribed or is it well defined? Obviously it is well defined. And does it elevated or depressed? So it is a elevated lesion. So is it assuming some geometrical shape or is it irregular? So it is assuming a geometrical shape of hemispherical. So you are seeing the hemispherical here. So is there any size difference or a size variation? So most of the lesions are less than 1 centimeter here, like approximately less than 1 centimeter. And so this I will tell you in combined way, that is, it is a well defined hemispherical less than 1 centimeter papular lesion present at the eyelid. So this is a term to decode the skin lesions. So in next image, so this is also similarly hemispherical less than 1 centimeter well-defined skin lesion, that is papule, present on the skin. In this image, we are seeing the peculiarisms. There is some depressed thing. So that depressed thing is called as umbilication. So something called as in abdomen, you have got umbilicus. Similarly, our lesion is also has got umbilicus. So hence the term umbilicated papular lesion. So, If you are going for the histopathological examination, we are going to see something like this. Can you be able to correlate between these two images? So in especially in skin, it is all about the correlation and decoding the terms. If you decode the terms, over 90% you are going to diagnose the diseases. So in this, can you able to decode this image? So in this image, we are seeing some volcanic eruption. That is something coming out of the earth or a central core of the earth, and it is bursting out of the surface. Similarly, there is something pink material which is bursting out of the epidermis. So this is epidermis, where you are seeing the basal keratinocytes, precursor layer, and striatum corneosum. So there is something pink material which is bursting out of the epidermis, similar to the volcanic eruption. Hence that term called as volcano sign. Sign is called as volcano sign, and the pink material is nothing but all this is the viral particles. And in close up view, this pathology, if you want to understand the pathology, the virus is going to enter the keratinocytes, that is epidermal cell, mainly suprabasal layer, something called a suprabasal cell layer. So it enters that layer and it tries to divide in the cytoplasm, not in the nucleus. It will divide in the cytoplasm, and correspondingly it will cause a cytopathic effect. There is an intracytoplasmic hyaline bodies are present in the molluscum disease. Those are called as molluscum bodies. So in this image, we are seeing some, this is a normal keratinocyte. This is the abnormal keratinocytes. That is something, it is distended and the nucleus is pushed to the periphery. Here you can see the peripheral portion of the nucleus. And at the same time, there is a pink hyaline material. That is, pink material is present in the cytoplasm. That is because the virus is divided, multiplying actively in the cytoplasm. Correspondingly, viral DNA, viral protein particles, all getting stained in this cytoplasm. Hence, it gives a hyaline material here. So this is a molluscum bodies, also known as Henderson-Peterson bodies. So it is an intracytoplasmic lesion. So in MCQ, they will be asking molluscum contagiosum virus is going to produce a new intracytoplasmic inclusion bodies. So if they in option, if they mentioned in nucleus intranuclear cytoplasmic inclusion bodies, then it is option is wrong. So go for the intracytoplasmic cytopathic bodies. Okay, for the treatment. So as we already told, that is molluscum virus is a spreads by contagious route, and one more route, that is sexually transmitted route. So in adults, it is most commonly sexually transmitted route, whereas in children, it is the most commonly contagious route. So this is a very peculiar feature, because adults are mostly sexually active, so there is a chance of transmission is high in with the sexually transmitted route, whereas in children, most of the, like, we love the children and we tend to hold the children when you see the children. So this, that is how the children is going to, in children it is a contagious, in adult it is a sexually transmitted route. So most of the viruses are resolving on its own. So similarly, the molluscum virus is also resolving on its own. And similarly, in 70% of the patients, we don't have to treat the patient exactly. You should just, it is a self-limiting. And remaining patient, if it is a cosmetically creating problem, and if it is growing on, if it is not going to resolve, then go for the cryotherapy modality. Nothing but a cryotherapy is a, therapy means treatment, cryo means cold. Cold induced treatment. Here, the cold is going to kill the virus, and then that is how the virus is going to killed by the therapy. So this is one modality. One more modality is like liquid phenol can be used, cantharidin can be used. Here they are going to initiate the inflammatory response, and that is how they are going to increase the cell-mediated immunity, and that is where the virus is going to eliminate from the body. So this is the treatment modality. And next, coming for the one MCQs, like how you are going to answer this MCQ, let me see. So our MCQ is like this: most adults become infected with the molluscum contagiosum. Why this route? That is, first our